I love the immensity of climate change. Throughout human history, civilization has faced and endured a myriad of adversities. Somehow we endure, and our ingenuity prevails. We find ways of taking things that are impossible and somehow making them possible. Today, we face an extinction-level challenge. Today, we face the biggest ecological collapse in over 200 million years. How do we even begin to wrap our heads around this? We have to learn to love the challenge. And at the very least, if we can't do that, we have to learn to love the immensity of the challenge. This is how I fell in love with it. If we consider that our planet has specific boundaries that must not be exceeded in order for it to be livable, unfortunately, we have already exceeded 6 out of 9 of them. We have released fossil fuels at an exponentially growing rate in the past 200 years. And unfortunately, we continue to release these fossil fuels. So the reality is, we have to learn to fall in love with immensity. We have to learn to fall in love with the immensity of climate change itself. This is the story of how I fell in love with it. At the end of the pandemic, I found myself in a dark place. I was experiencing a level of success, and I was very happy and proud of the work that I was doing with a team of collaborators. But somewhere in my heart of hearts, I knew that something was actually missing. And worse yet, I knew that it was something very important. You see, I realized that I had become complicit in ignoring the scale of the problem, which meant that I was part of this problem. The moment I realized this, I made the decision to stop and remember why it is that I do what I do, which is out of a profound love for humanity and our shared future. I realized that somewhere along the way I had lost that, and I decided to find it again. And so I set out in search of something. I wasn't quite sure of what it was. I didn't know what it would be, but I had the feeling and the certainty that it would be immense. I didn't have to understand everything about it in order to find it. It was then that I discovered the world of carbon removal, something that I knew almost nothing about. If you don't know what it is, it's the deliberate removal of carbon from our atmosphere and the safe storage of it for at least 1,000 years. The bigness of the language around carbon removal really fascinated me and pulled me in. I knew I had met my match, and particularly when I found the company that I now work for. We practice carbon dioxide removal using a regenerative agricultural technique called enhanced rock weathering. We do this in Brazil and work directly with farmers there. The beauty of this process is that it actually benefits the land as well as these farming communities in a myriad of ways. The need for CO2 removal is absolutely staggering. It cannot be understated. We need to remove over 1,000 billion tons of CO2 before 2100. It's hard to imagine, again, absolute immensity, right? But for context, we have emitted 1,500 billion tons already in the past 200 years. Unfortunately, we have to remove this carbon in 77 years. Our response to it has to be abnormal. It has to be extreme. Think of the graph you saw at the beginning. It was quite steady like this, and then that's basically what we have to do. This is the era of an abnormal commitment to each other. This is the era of an abnormal love for each other. So again, how do we fall in love with this immensity? First, we have to remember that immensity opens wide the doors of our hearts. It sends our imaginations into places of joy and pioneering that they could never go to unless we do encounter it. and embrace it. Second, immensity frees us from the tyranny of normal, because normal is long gone. And lastly, immensity is an invitation. It's an initiation. The scale of the problem dissolves our mediocrity because it has to. So how do we say yes to this incredible invitation? How do we fall in love with this? First, we have to rewrite the future. Everything that we think we know that is certain, it may or may not happen. Nature is certainly not going to do what she always has. So we have to adjust as well. We have to come forward with more love and ingenuity than we ever have before. Second, we have to embrace limitless work. We have to let go of the fetters of our experiences and our expertise, and we have to go beyond. We have to do more than we have ever done, and we have to do it faster than we have ever done it. And lastly, we have to remember that it can be effortless. It actually can be easy. I say that, and I promise you that working on climate change is actually easier than reading about it, by far. So we rewrite the future, make it a limitless one, and we let it be easy together. Recently, I visited some of the farmers who work with my company in Brazil. One of them took us to a very special place near his farm. It's known as the heart of Sao Paulo. The spot was marked with these huge wooden beams like a sacred site. It's impossible to describe, but it was known to those who knew it. It stood gently on a hill, and you could see in every direction for over 50 kilometers. You could see every major city of Sao Paulo from this spot. What I did not know at the time was that Sao Paulo actually has the nickname of being the heart of Brazil. Standing in this spot, next to this heart of a place that was so immense I could not even fathom how big it was like standing at the edge of the sky. There are no words truly to describe this feeling. It was a silent pulse, and I think that it could only be perceived by those who cared enough and who dared enough to feel it. That was the moment that I realized that stepping into immensity is a decision. The moment was not lost on me, and I made that decision personally, and in fact, made a promise to the land as well. You see, I didn't have to understand the immensity of climate change in order to embrace all that it was calling me to do, and with my whole heart, full of love. So my invitation to you today is to fall in love with the immensity of climate change. Let the bigness of it in, let it change you. Get to work with as much love and ingenuity than you could possibly muster, bigger than the sky even, and then do it with even more love than that. Because that is what it will take. Thank you.